This is the key for you to get anything you want in your life, but particularly what we talk about today with your weight loss. If you feel stuck on where you are right now, if you feel stuck that you just can't lose more weight, you can't change your body, I'm gonna show you how to, but more importantly, I'm gonna show you the psychology behind you moving from where you are right now to where you want to be without a doubt. SciFit's Triple, I just named this one, by the way, just before. It's always good to have names to things. SciFit's Triple Tornado. I love that name. By the way, I got a free program out there right now that has everything I'm talking about here right now. You got your training, you got your nutrition, and more important, you got how to develop new habits, and more importantly, how to install and remove bad habits. I put that in together into a bundle, right? Exactly plans what to eat, exactly what to, how to train, and exactly how to implement and install this as a new routine and habits into your lifestyle. It's all for free right now. You can send me a DM. You might already have received a DM, or you can go into the domain scifit.com.au/free. Completely for free in there. A bundle of my best programs you can get access to there right now. But the triple, SciFit's Triple Tornado, now we're talking about the how to. And that's my metanology? See, English is my second language, so I'm allowed to do that. That's my philosophy that I'm doing with my clients and how I'm structuring training, nutrition, and actually getting results with their body. So if you're talking about the diet first, I'm using something called carb cycling / calorie cycling, right? Carb cycling and calorie cycling is set up so you are eating your carbs and your calories on an interval throughout the week to optimize for the best results. If you're trying to lose weight right now, oftentimes, what we normally are doing, our natural response is just to drop the calories and implement some cardio, do some running, and drop the calories, which will work to an extended period of time. What happens when you start dropping your calories is that, imagine your body is like a fire, right? You're dropping your calories, fire, you keep taking the logs, you keep taking the wood away from the fire, you're dropping the calories until you're hitting the bottom, until you're hitting the scratch, the edge of like, okay, there's not more to take off. What happens to the fire? The fire burns out, the fire dies, right? The same happens with your body and your metabolism. So your body, your metabolism is one, it's regulated and it's controlled by your hormones and, you know, genetics and so on, right? Your thyroid and stuff, right? It's all individual from person to person. But one thing we all can control is the amount of calories, right? Logs we are putting into the fire, into the body. Meaning when you're doing a carb cycling, you're spiking, you're putting logs into the fire, and that body starts picking up on that and thinks, oh wow, there's flames again. It starts burning, right? So carb cycling is really, really an amazing tool for when you're trying to transform your body. I use it even when I try to gain weight. I'm not just like putting weight on. I'm gradually going up and down. On a day off, I might eat a little bit less. On a heavy leg day, I might double my carbs, right? On a moderate day when I'm training chest, arms, and so on, I might go in between. So I'm regulating my carbohydrates, in particular when we're talking about that. More broad, we can just do calorie cycling, right? So I'm regulating my calories and my carbs after my activity level, right? So you got like one or two different phases, one, two, or three, like a low, medium, and a high. And you implement them throughout the week so it suits your activity level. When you do that, first of all, you are preventing to spill over. So you're not just like going 2000 calories. And on some days you might do fuck all, right? And you might only hit those like 14, 15, 1600 calories, right? Then you're like, oh, I'm 500 too much. You're spilling over. So that's one thing you're preventing for spilling over on the days when you're not doing anything. Second point is what I'm talking about there before. You trigger your body to think that it's getting more calories. So when you're spiking your calories up with calories for one or two more days during the week, well, the day after, your body's like, wow, I got fuel. I'm ready to roll. And you're going straight down again to doing a moderate on a low calorie diet. Your body, your metabolism is just like rocket, right? It will just start burning, it will start working for you. And that's the most important thing when you're talking your diet. Your main point looking after your diet is not just healthy food, but it's that you are feeding your metabolism. And we're talking about 3-in-1. But if you're talking in a gym facility, I want you to work with 3 different energy systems when you're at the gym for the 45 minutes, an hour and a half you're there, max, right? Meaning, I want you to do some sort of like steady cardio, right? I want you to do weight resistance workout. And number 3, I want you to do some high interval training. And again, the how-to is a very, very small part of everything I'm teaching and everything we've been going through today. But again, you need to know the how-to. You wanna get your heart rate up, you wanna get your body turned on with some steady cardio. You do that for 10, 15 minutes. I want you to go in and then smash out an intensive weight session, 30 minutes, 35 minutes, 45 minutes if you have time to it, right? Great contact to your muscles, become stronger, work on progressive overload, work on increasing your weight week for week, right? Become stronger at the gym, still with good form and technique. And number 3, I want you to work on high interval training. High interval training as a finisher, as a metabolic finisher afterwards. To add on to that, I want you to start thinking about what are you doing elsewhere? What are you doing with your time, your movements and activity when you're not at the gym, right? When you're not at the gym, how are you walking around? How are you moving? How are you standing up? Are you sitting at a desk the whole day? If you're sitting at a desk the whole day, moving in your car, going into the elevator, you need to be extra intense and work hard and push yourself in those 60 minutes you got at the gym there, right? But be aware of how can I become more active and move in general more throughout the day, right? It lays in there. But if you're thinking about the hacks and techniques we're talking about, work on 3 different energy systems when you're there. Not just work in one, not just do cardio, not just do circuit training, not just do weight training. Do them all 3 all at once, and I promise you, you will make your body sculpt, you will gain more muscle mass, you will lose more weight, right? Within that session there, because you're working on the whole body. You're working on your whole body there, right? And number 3 is your power routines. Power routines, meaning your morning and your night routines. How you set up the day is how you finish the day. How you finish the day is how you start the day, right? So we talked about that many, many times. You know I'm very big on it. If you follow my stories, you know I'm waking up at 5 a.m. every single day. This is part of who I am. And this is back to question 1 we talked about before. Who are you as a person? What is the I am you're putting? What is the thing you're putting behind the I am? I am strong, confident, and consistent. I am strong, confident, and consistent. I am that. Guaranteed 100%, right? I'm not that all the time, but that's why I'm working on it every single day, right? Because it gets taken from you. You need to involve and develop this thing here. It's not just about now I'm going on a diet, I'm now gonna train hard, and now I'm gonna look amazing in 12 weeks. It's not. It's a back to the 2 first point we talked about in the previous video. And then it's about backing it up, right? With a bulletproof system, a bulletproof pack that can work for you every single day. So what you do in the morning and what you do at nighttime will set up the standard, the pace, right? The pace for the rest of the day. I promise you, your strongest desire is to remain consistent with who you see ourselves as, or who we see ourselves as, right? So again here, there's a video just before I filmed where I covered these 2 points there. It's just because the camera went off there. But again, this is what we talked about today. If you feel stuck with your weight loss, you're not feeling like you're moving forward, right? Don't just look at the how-to, right? The mechanics. Go in and Google the next diet, or what should I do? Should I eat? Should I not eat? Don't look at that first. Look at you first, right? Get a 360 degree of where you are, who you are. What have you been telling yourself leading up to now, right? Am I big boned? Am I always late? Am I always procrastinating? Am I always giving up after 6 weeks? Who are you? This is gonna tell you what is holding you back. I guarantee you. Number 2.